Performance Centre here in Manchester. We're here for the Sure Shot National Cup Finals, and we're bringing you the third game of today, which is the Under-18 Women's Final between CoLA Southwark Pride and Ipswich. My name's Kaz Bullock. I'm here with Adam Masters. We're with you throughout the day on the Basketball England YouTube channel, bringing you all the games. The Under-18 Men's game will follow this one at 5:45. So two great games already so far. We're about 4 minutes away from tip-off of the Under-18 Women's Final. And this is CoLA and Ipswich. Now this is a rivalry between these two teams, these age groups, Division 1 WEAVL. Any level of basketball, you've got Ipswich and CoLA fighting out for bragging rights.
Well, this is the rematch, right?
Yep, this is the rematch of last year's final. CoLA came out on top of that one, 6-41. And this season, both teams have played together in the Division 1, in the WEAVL. They're playing together here at under-18s level. A lot of different league play that they play as a group together. And every time they come up against each other, it's always, always a tough matchup. So CoLA currently sitting at 3-0 in the Southern Premier Division. They beat the Bracknell Cobras, Haringey Hawks and the Manchester Mystics to make it through to the final today. But in the league, their closest game this season, Adam, it was last weekend. It was against Ipswich. They won by 9. So if they've been winning an average of games by 23 points, they beat Ipswich by 9. And we know Ipswich are a tough matchup for them in particular.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, I'm really looking forward to this one. Two great teams, two great programs. And you always love to do a game in the final where there is genuine rivalry between the two as well. They know each other well, and we're just going to have to see what happens. I mean, it's the return to Manchester, the hometown girl. Liv Foster is in town, and we know how dangerous she can be from outside the arc. So I know she's going to want to put on a show in front of a few old family and friends here in Manchester.
She absolutely is. So Liv Forster for Ipswich, she's the leading scorer in the WEAVL, 24.8 points per game. She averages 20.2 in Division 1, which is second in the league. She's third in assists in the WEAVL, seventh in steals in D1. She's got caps for GB under-18, England under-18, and CoLA's coach Jackson Gibbons has called her arguably the best scorer in junior basketball. She is going to be a problem for CoLA today.
Well, we know what Liv likes to do. She likes to shoot a lot from the outside, and that is just her style of game. So, you know, she's going to shoot a lot, but she's going to score a lot. And if she gets hot, then you're in trouble. Because once she gets into a rhythm hitting those three-pointers, it's game over. Now, she, I think, is really, really going to be up for this one last year.
It's a similar thing, isn't it? We saw with the Mystics game earlier. Players that have been here, been to these finals, competed in a finals atmosphere, and come up a little bit short, it fuels you to go back into the next one. You've experienced it, you know how close you were, and you just want to get over the line. So thank you to everybody joining us on YouTube. We are going to be on the Basketball England YouTube channel all day long, bringing you the rest of this game and the under-18 men's game at 5:45 today.
Hit those likes.
Like and subscribe. Follow on social media. 6,000 subscribers on the Basketball England YouTube channel. You love to see it, Adam, don't you?
You do.
Growing the game
it.
In this country, highlighting the talent that we have on display.
And plenty of other people to like and follow while you're at it on your socials. Basketball England, of course. It's sponsors for today: Sure Shot, Wilson, Dynamic, Sports Serve. Everybody coming together. And then, of course, you've got the social media guys. The family are over there in the corner. Hooping and Looting, go check them out for all your jersey needs. Mab guy, everything. Chris is over there. He's always courtside doing his video stuff. And, of course, the big dog, Nate, providing the sounds in the arena. And his partner in crime, Stan, who's on the mic emceeing. Follow them all on Instagram, Twitter, and everywhere else. And of course, you can follow Focus Hoops, Hooping Cassie B.
Yeah, Focus Hoops, Instagram, Twitter, focushoops.com. Got some great content out there. And again, thank you to everybody that makes this possible. Thank you to all the volunteers, to Basketball England for putting on such an incredible event, and for Ralston and his team. Always, always a pleasure to work these finals for Basketball England.
And of course, I wouldn't be doing my job as a podcaster if I didn't shout out the Below the Rim podcast, the UK's number one BBL podcast.
So, ball is up, and it's going to be Jacobs and Gibbons for the tip. Ipswich come away with the first possession. Edwards powers to the basket and gets Ipswich on the board. And that's a great start to the game for Ipswich, straight off the tip. And teams playing with pace here early on. Sager swings it over. Three-point shot is up, but no good. Bia passes round. Sager for CoLA on the baseline, got three on the shot clock. And that one doesn't fall. It's going to be a shot clock violation. Great defense from Ipswich to force the turnover. And Adam, whilst we talk about this being a rivalry, these are two very different teams from the teams that were here this time last year. So for CoLA, Violet Stutz, the only returning player that was in that final this time last year, as Forster brings the ball up the court for Ipswich. And stolen away by Jacobs. Passes to Jacobs on the baseline. Shots up, and that one doesn't fall. And again, another 24-second shot clock violation for CoLA. Some great defense from Ipswich. Forster, pass inside, and it's just going to get knocked out of bounds. So end line CoLA ball, Stutz with the inbound, gets into Uyuele. Clark, maybe in the corner, stripped by Forster. Forster coming down the court, and she's blocked. And there's going to be a travel call, so Ipswich get the ball back. Ipswich with a quick 2-0 lead here in the first quarter. We've got 8:13 to go. And again, Adam, maybe see a little bit of nerves early on. You just want to see a few shots go through the basket and start to feel comfortable on court. It's an intense atmosphere here.
Well, I mean, who wouldn't be nervous coming into a game like this? You're in a big arena, big noisy crowd, and a lot of people watching online. But it's like we said all day, you've got to get the first shot down. You've got to start feeling it, you know, that way. You know, for Liv, for example, when she hits her first three, she'll ease into it a little bit more.
So Louisa Gibbons at the line. She's shooting two. Saw Louisa playing earlier last year for the Under-18 Women's England squad at the Four Nations tournament. And she's also playing Division 1, playing WEABL as well. averaging 13.8 points per game, 8.6 rebounds, which is good for eighth in the WEABL. Again, Adam, another really exciting squad full of players that we have, and the talent that we have on both of these teams.
Who are we watching, Kaz? Who is going to be one day in the Olympics or the Commonwealth Games or playing at Eurobasket for GB? Because I'm pretty sure that we've seen people today and on this game and in the next game that are very much going to be there.
Absolutely, that's half the fun of these competitions. Jacobs pulls down the rebound and a bit of a miscommunication on that pass. And Felicia Jacobs, Adam, playing for CoLA, she actually won the Under-16s National Cup last year with Haringey, so having moved over to CoLA, she was the MVP of that game.
Okay.
So really great to see her being able to step up into the next level. And Olivia Manning gets her first points of the game, and some really tough D here from Ipswich, really pressuring CoLA. And that's almost what we're used to seeing from the CoLA team.
Well, you can see Coach Nick Drain pacing up and down in front of his bench there. He's certainly hyped up for this one.
Gibbons against Jacobs, round to Forster. Forster, great pass inside to Edwards, who finishes.
That's how you got to do it. Ipswich going for the full court press as well.
Going to be a foul call. That's going to be on Ipswich. On Christabel Osorobo, her first. And CoLA looking to get the ball in. Jacobs is knocked away. Gibbons is there. Pass just a bit too strong for Osorobo.
Just a little bit too much sauce on the pass there.
Again, Ipswich really piling the pressure on defensively. And Sega with it inbound. Against Osorobo, has to heave it, gets it across, Stutz, pass inside, stolen away, Osorobo, over to Forster, puts the floater up, banks it in off the glass, and that gets Forster on the board. Stutz is doubled, Gibbons fighting
defense.
For it.
Look at his defense already.
And jump ball, gonna go the way of CoLA, but love the hustle from this early on from Ipswich.
Yeah, Ipswich are feeling it.
And I think, you know, they may have remembered last year that it came out a little bit slower to start with.
A little bit flat.
Absolutely no problem with that today. And again, a really great packed crowd here at the National Basketball Performance Centre. We've got drums, we've got noise, we've got travelling fans from Ipswich really showing their support.
I mean, Ipswich have always travelled in numbers, Kaz. This is crazy, how loud they are.
And that's too strong there for CoLA. So Ipswich forcing another turnover. Forster bringing it up for Ipswich. Working against Stutz. Comes up against Jacobs. Floater is up. That one's no good. Ball's back with Ipswich. Offensive board. Manning kicks it out to Forster. Gibbons calls for the three. It's good! Huge bucket from Louisa Gibbons.
The bank is open.
And Louisa Gibbons, one of the taller players on the court, tallest player for Ipswich. You don't necessarily expect her to step back out for a three, but she can hit those.
I think at 6'2", she's possibly the tallest player out there today.
And we're going to see Aaliyah Clark check into the game for Felicia Jacobs. And Gibbons completes the three-point play. gives Ipswich a very early 12-0 lead over CoLA. And you can see how excited this Ipswich crowd is.
Okay.
So leading the way for Ipswich. Yasmin Edwards has 4 points. And Louisa Gibbons has 4 points as well. CoLA yet to get on the score sheet. As we said, a very different looking CoLA team from this time last year, from some of the finals we saw them play in last year. Players that have graduated, moved over the over 18 mark, still playing in Division 1, but yeah, a very different looking CoLA team. But Adam as well, so both these teams have players that play at Division 1 level, at WEABL level as well. How much does that help them when they come into games like this? Because they're obviously playing up, they're playing at the second highest level for women in the country.
Yeah. Well, I mean, it helps them a lot. I mean, these players, we forget how much they do for other teams as well as the one that we're watching right now. But the best experience for them is out there on the court. And if you're playing with players that are older than you, it's a great opportunity to learn and develop your own game. But certainly both these teams out here, Ipswich and CoLA, a long tradition of producing great basketball players. And you'd expect these two clubs to be here on days like this.
Definitely. So back underway in the first quarter, 6:30 to go. Ipswich with a 12-0 lead. Stutz swings it round. Side to Kerside. And nearly knocked away by Forster. CoLA keep it alive. Clark, 4 seconds to shoot. Kabir's shot's good. And that's going to get CoLA on the board. Forster with a tough shot, doesn't fall. And Osorobo and Kersite fighting for the rebound. It's going to be a jump ball and it's going to stay with Ipswich. Osorobo inside to Gibbons. Gibbons backing down. Forster's out underneath the basket. Tries to pass it out, but it's intercepted. And great D from Ipswich. Forster comes up with it.
Oh, lucky.
But the defence of Ipswich is just smothering.
Great hustle from Ipswich there.
Kabir, round to Stutz. Kabir gets it back and tries a three again. Doesn't drop, but Clark's there for the rebound. And we've got another jump ball. That is the way of CoLA Southwark Pride. So, Captain Violet Stutz. Inbound. Beer shots up. That's too strong, but rebound Clark. Kerside tries a three. That doesn't drop. Edwards coming one on three. He's going all the way. Off the glass, Jasmine Edwards with a tough basket for Ipswich. A great pass over to Kerside. And she gets fouled on that possession. As we see on the replay, Jasmine Edwards going one on three against CoLA. Banks it off the glass. That is such a tough, tough move. So that foul was on Louisa Gibbons, her first. And it's going to send Esther Kersite to the line. And Esther playing GB under-16s. So again, great representation for the future of British basketball in this country. One of two from the line, but offensive board, CoLA. The finish, the putback, Forster. She's going to get fouled on the floor. So it's end line Ipswich ball. That foul is on Kerry Sleach. The first. Sorobo. Yes, a friendly roll.
Took his time but got there in the end.
And that gives Ipswich a 16-4 lead. Just under 5 minutes to play in the first quarter. Soleu. Right to Oyuele. Oyuele gets it back. Kabir got six on the shot clock. Clark round to Oyuele. Soleu. That shot's no good. And Ipswich powering down the court, playing with pace. Osorobo takes a tumble into the
She really did. She said she went straight into Coach Drain's feet there. He's still arguing with the referee, though.
Forster with the inbound for Ipswich. Into Gibbons. Hand off to Forster. Thought about the three. Spins against Clark. Comes up against three Ipswich players. Doesn't get it to drop. Oyuele. Over to Sega. Oyuele gets it back. She's got space. Three doesn't drop for Ipswich. Edwards is ahead on the break. And
great basket.
Can it and the foul. Yasmin Edwards.
Well, Edwards did so well there because the ball was slightly out of reach. She did really well to compose herself, make the catch, make the bucket, and send herself to the line. Great play from Ipswich.
And Violet Stutz checking back in for Shea Oyuele, for CoLA. As Yasmin Edwards with a chance to complete the three-point play. She's got 8 points in the game so far, make it nine. Nothing but net on that one.
What a start for her.
And I'm sure that league loss against CoLA last week is going to be fresh in the minds.
I'd say so.
Forster for three. Doesn't fall. CoLA come up with the rebound. Great hustle again from Ipswich, fighting for the jump ball.
And the thing with that play there as well, we had the perfect view of it. If Liv Forster gets a look, it's the ball's going up.
Yeah.
She doesn't think about it, she just shoots. And that's what makes her a great spot-up shooter.
Give her a bit of daylight, and it's a problem. Oh, Edwards again with another tough basket.
Well, what a start for her. She's having a great game.
10 points for her so far. Stutz passes inside. Kersight backing down. Foul. Just checking, is that a foul on the floor or on the play?
I think it's on Edwards, you know.
But it's on Gibbons, so that's her second. As we see Oliver Manning check out and Katie York come in for Ipswich. So it's end line CoLA ball, Stutz to inbound, over to Sega. Sega for three. That's not going to fall. Osorobo coming up the court for Ipswich, and Stutz nearly steals it away. Gibbons keeps control.
Gibbons did well there to control that one and get the pass up.
Swings it round. Forster got seven on the shot clock. Shot up and in and out. But Liv Forster will head to the line to shoot three as she's bumped while she was shooting. And as you said, Adam, you know, as soon as Liv gets a good look at the basket, the shot's up.
Well, I mean, she spends so much time practicing that shot. She knows exactly where the basket is. She knows exactly the position to let go. So she knew that when she popped up there, as you can see,
and
she got the look.
See there on the replay, that great screen from Katie York as well, giving Liv the space to get round and get the shot off, block the defender out. First shot pops out for Forster. rims out. And it is good. Takes a lift of three so far in the game. 3 points and three assists for Liv. As Sega gets the inbound for CoLA into Cabia. And knocked out Adam. Ipswich just relentless defensively.
The play, well, relentless is the word I'd use. You can't get through them at the moment.
So inbound Ipswich. York. Round to Forster. Forster's got Stutz on her. Forster shots up. Too strong. And again, a great hustle for the jump ball. That's going to go with CoLA. And you love to see these players just going after the ball.
Well, it amazes me just how tough these players are at every age group. None of them are afraid to get on the floor, get into a tussle, try and win that ball.
CoLA get it in, Sega. Over to Stutz, needs to get it over the halfway line, and that is going to be an 8 second violation.
Well, what did you say a couple of minutes ago? This Ipswich defense, they're
relentless.
Not easing up even a little bit. They're going for the full court press, and it's working so well for him. Stick with it.
And I think it's interesting to see. You see the difficulty Ipswich maybe have had in the final last year, and they've really done a really good job of being able to adapt. They'll have been familiar with CoLA, yeah, obviously, throughout the years, but playing them last weekend as well, I'm sure, will have helped these two teams scout each other for this weekend in particular.
Yeah, I'm sure they've been watching a lot of tape this week at practice, talking about past games.
And Osorobo defending the inbound for Sega. Sega struggling to get it over the outstretched arms of Osorobo. CoLA do get it across the halfway line. Kersites. Stutz gets it back. Sega. 6 seconds on the shot clock. Sega kicks it out to Stutz. For three. That's too strong. Good look, though, for Violet Stutz, and we know she can hit that shot. Pass from Forster to Edwards. Just can't finish. But a great look inside Edwards in a good position under the basket. Yasmin Edwards going to take a seat for Ipswich after a fantastic 11-point first quarter. And Kerry Sleet checks back in. Her is it stolen by Forster and she drives
great
the basket,
basket
to lay in. Stutz to Sega. Bia driving inside, can't get it to drop. Osorobo's there for the rebound. And I think there was a bit of a confusion there, but CoLA steal it away, and Gloria Kabir is fouled, so she's going to head to the line. A timeout called. Oh, apologies, substitution calls. As Edwards is coming back in, so she had a good 3 seconds rest.
Looked like it, yeah.
So Gloria Cabia at the line. Spins in. Fall, Edwards grabs the rebound. That may be why she was put back in. Edwards going all the way down the court and double dribble call. Just lost control a little bit towards the end. And ball goes back with CoLA. So we've got a 24-7 Ipswich lead with 52.5 seconds to go in the first quarter. Duffy hands it over. Stutz gets it. Murphy. Over to Stutz. CoLA struggling to get the ball inside. Ipswich just in the way, clogging up the paint as Kersite manages to drop the layup in. And we've got a quick stop in play.
CoLA have really got to try and find a way to counteract this Ipswich defense because it's tenacious right now.
It really is as well. And Ipswich, you know, both teams very deep benches, deep teams as well. So you take someone out, give them a rest. They're not going to lay out on the defense. They're going to keep going. I think we're just checking. I think the officials are just checking. Is it an issue with the scoreboard? The shot clock? So we're currently showing at 28 seconds left in the first quarter. And Ipswich ball. Leach controlling things for Ipswich. Passes around to Manning, inside to Edwards. Edwards, great move to the basket, just can't finish. And stolen away by York. This is just smothering, Adam.
They're all over him. I mean, how do you react to that? You know, they're just all over them. And Edwards is having himself a ball game so far. I mean, 11 points already.
Couple of rebounds.
But doing a lot of hard work on defense as well.
So that was a last foul that took Ipswich over the line. So Esther Kersite shooting two. First shot rolls in. Board CoLA. 4 seconds. Forster's got the ball. 2 seconds. Puts it up. And that doesn't go.
Well, if you're going to bet on somebody that's going to make one of those mid-court shots, it's going to be Liv Forster.
So 24 to 20. Ipswich lead after the first quarter. Leading the scorers is Yasmin Edwards. 11 points for Ipswich. And CoLA. Rory Kabir has 4 points and Esther Kersite has 4 points as well. So make sure to stick with us on the Basketball England YouTube channel for the last game of the day coming up after this one. 17:45, Under-18 Men's Sure Shot National Cup. It's the London Legends versus the London Elites. And tomorrow be the senior national cup, the women's final and the men's final, and John Hobbs will be bringing you those games as well. So make sure to stick around for today and tomorrow. A great weekend of basketball here at the National Basketball Performance Center. And if you can make it down, tickets still on sale at the door, come down and check it out. Add to this intensely loud crowd noise.
Oh yeah, Beyond the Dull Illusions wearing headphones that are supposedly noise cancelling, but all you can hear right now is Ipswich fans. And one thing that's for sure, Kaz, every game Ipswich play, especially in a final, one thing you're going to see and hear is Liv's brother over there with his cowbell bringing the noise. Last year at Final Four, me and Stan from Big Dog Ballin had to commentate with him right next to us, and it was hilarious the whole time. Always there for his sister, you love it.
Love to see the support again. Great travelling support from Ipswich and from CoLA as well.
Yeah.
So coming up also at the National Basketball Performance Centre next month, we have two GB Eurobasket qualifiers. February the 9th against Estonia and February the 12th against Portugal. Early bird tickets are on sale online right now. So get your tickets. Come on down. It's going to be a really, really exciting couple of games and crucial games as GB try and qualify for the Eurobasket Championship.
Absolutely. Who wouldn't want to come down here and see Holly Winterburn, Azania Stewart, Shanice Beckford-Norton, Carly Samuelson if she's here, Chantel Handy.
Come down and
Semi Fag Bentley, come down and see some of the best British players.
But back on court, we have some of the future stars of GB and England on court at the moment.
Which I'm sure we're seeing a few of, Kaz.
Definitely, we definitely are. So Forster fouled on that shot. She's going to head to the line for two. And Forster, again, a player that does a really good job of drawing that foul. She heads to the line, strong free throw shooter. I mean, she's a strong shooter, full stop.
Yeah.
But able to get to the line and draw those fouls.
Definitely. Very tough player as well, so if she needs to penetrate, she can do that too. She makes the second one there.
2 of 2 from the line, up to 7 points in the game. And Ipswich having laid off the full court defence for perhaps the first possession. CoLA get the ball across court. Stutz round to Duffy. Inside to Kersai. Stutz, she's got space in the corner. Duffy kicks it out to Kabir. Duffy, long two. No good. And Edwards. To Forster for three. Rolls out. Ball's tapped. And Ipswich keep it alive. Gibbons working inside, steps through. Looks like Duffy almost got a hand on that to stop the shot. And Forster nearly intercepts it. But it's going to go out of bounds. Last touch, Ipswich. So we see Shea Oyuele check back in for CoLA. That's a Duffy, Zara Duffy controlling things. Jacobs round to Stutz. Jacobs driving inside. That's a tough shot. Comes up against Gibbons, who strips it. Gibbons pass inside to Edwards.
Did well to get that rebound.
That was tough. She was quite far underneath the basket. Forster on the baseline.
There you go. It bubbles out.
So unlucky. Stutz, putting it round to Duffy. Oyuele for three. That one's too strong. So 8-18 to play in the second quarter. Ipswich with a 26-10 lead. They've gotten out strong really early on. Stutz on the inbound. Duffy, she tries a three. Oh, pops out. Jacobs with the rebound and the putback. Oh, doesn't go back in. Edwards. Off the glass, Jasmine Edwards, another tough basket. She's been doing it all game long. I think she's trying to find the most difficult shots she can take. And
seriously, yeah.
Jacobs to OULA. They played together in Haringey last year in the 16. Duffy. Stutz inside to Jacobs. Jacobs, she's triple teamed. Manages to get the shot off, but it doesn't drop. And Ipswich just drawing all their players to Jacobs when she gets inside. They know how much of a problem she is inside. They know she's a threat. They'll have seen her last year. They've seen her throughout the season.
Well, CoLA having a nightmare on offense right now. Only 3 points in this quarter.
Forster keeps it alive. Hands it off to Gibbons. And travel call on Ipswich. Substitution, Ipswich. Murphy back to OULA. He's got space for three and hits. Shea OULA with a big three for CoLA. That's her first points of the game. As Edwards, another tough shot, and we got a wedgie. We got our first wedgie of the weekend, Adam.
Well, wouldn't be a finals weekend without at least one wedgie, and we got a good one there.
I think we, someone needs to fix this.
Somebody needs
to get
some hops. Stan.
Oh, Stan. Stan the man.
Uh-oh. Who needs a broomstick when you got Stan there? I like play from Stan from Big Dog Ball in there.
Back underway, Duffy for CoLA. Ipswich with a 15-point lead. Jacobs out to Stoops, swings it round. Duffy pulls up for two. She's going to get fouled on the shot. And I think that is on Manning. As that sends Zara Duffy to the line. First shot's good. Two of two from the line for Duffy. Great shooting. Ipswich with a 13-point lead. 6:37 to go in the half. Forster. Shot up, and that is good.
Great shot.
She's got nine. Stutz passes out. Stutz to Duffy for three. Gets her own rebound. And tough move going against Louisa Gibbons.
Really tough move there. Zara Duffy there, getting two much needed points.
Forster drives. And CoLA come up with it. Duffy out to OULA. Stutz. Jacobs and Adam, looking at the way Ipswich is set up defensively, they're leaving the arc open as Yasmin Edwards again lays it in on fast break.
Well, what a game Yasmin Edwards is having so far. That puts her on 15 points for the game. I think she wanted a piece of the MVP action.
She's certainly playing like one. OULA puts up a three, doesn't go. Forster. Over to Osorobo. Kicks it out. And three is up. Linnamore gets on the score board for Ipswich. And Ipswich is firing both offensively and defensively well. And if you look, Adam, how they're set up, they're not coming out to the three-point line. They look to be just trying to clog the paint and stop that drive inside.
But at the same time, it's almost like Ipswich are almost inviting them to shoot from the outside, knowing that the three-point shot's not as high a percentage. Almost like they're goading them to take the shots so they can just get the ball live and hopefully pick up the rebound.
Get it back. I mean, it's working for them so far.
Seems to be working so far. But what CoLA can't do is fall for the trap and shoot too many threes that aren't going in.
Yeah, and they've got Jacobs inside. There you go, as you see, going to the basket. Doesn't drop, but Jacobs, a very, very tough presence inside, very difficult to counter.
And it's 6'2" as well. Why would you use a high post player like that?
So, time out after that second foul on Aaliyah Clark for CoLA. Ipswich have a 35-17 lead here with 4:09 to play. Clearly that final last year when CoLA won 68-41, I mean, they've nearly matched their total now before halftime. That will be in their minds
yeah.
as they're playing in this game as they're going to go into half-time, and having come out incredibly strong.
Well, I'm glad that CoLA are managing to find a way back into the game. Because obviously they've been very, very slow to score in this quarter. But they're chipping away at it, and it's what we always say, trying to get that lead down to 10 or under at half-time. And they've done a pretty good job to get back into it. But, I mean, how do you answer the defensive pressure that Ipswich are putting on them right now?
It's tough, isn't it? I mean, you've got a full-court press. Players are getting double. It's difficult to even get the ball over the half-court line. And I feel like these are the things we said about CoLA last year when we watched them. It's, it's a very interesting dynamic.
Yeah.
But I think if you're CoLA, you've just got to keep going. You've got to chip into this. It is tough to break the press, but you've got to be aware if there's so many players down one end. Obviously, it's a risky pass to get it over the halfway line, but you're going to have to do some of those quarterback passes, the long-term passes. So, back underway here on court. It's going to be Ipswich ball with Louisa Gibbons to inbound. She gets it into Forster. Forster working against Stutz, into Gibbons. Gibbons, she's doubled, hands it off. Ball's loose, going to be a jump ball call. And we've had several jump ball calls in this game. We need this on a stat sheet.
Yeah, you're going to be right,
The second JLC.
Yeah.
So Forster inbound, round to Lidamore. Osorobo inside to Gibbons, great pass, and Gibbons can't quite finish up. Stutz pulls the rebound down. It over to Duffy.
She wants to get a look at how much space Ipswich are allowing at the three-point line.
Loads of space, and that one pops in and out. So Gibbons gets the rebound. Going all the way, end-to-end to Louisa Gibbons. 6 points to go along with her four rebounds. Ipswich back to picking up full court. Clark spins, scoop layup, doesn't drop. Gibbons with another rebound, fighting for it with Clark, and jump ball.
Jump ball, why not? I think we need a jump ball stat. We should go and speak to the table about having it.
And time out. The teams are going to talk things over. Ipswich with a 20-point lead. We've got 3 minutes to go in the half. Once again, thank you to everybody that's joined us on the Basketball England YouTube channel. We'll be here all afternoon. Our next game coming up after this one at 5:45 is the Under-18s men's game between the London Legends and the London Elite. Another exciting game.
I'd imagine some big rivalry there, both London teams. It's going to be a great game.
And then tomorrow we have the Senior National Cup Finals. And the women's game will be first, the Thames Valley Cavaliers taking on the Reading Rockets to kick things off.
And that'll be you and Mr. Hobbs, right?
Me and John Hobbs, yes.
And then I believe the men's final, Jason Swain, I believe is over.
It's going to be a good one, so make sure to tune in to the Basketball England YouTube channel, or if you're in Manchester, come on down to the National Basketball Performance Centre, get your tickets, and come and join this ever-growing crowd that we're seeing here.
And while you're at it, don't forget to like and subscribe to the Basketball England YouTube channel and follow on all social media platforms.
So teams coming back on court. CoLA here, you want to have a little bit of a strong finish to the half, going to half-time.
Yeah.
Having cut into this 20-point lead. And Ipswich just want to keep doing what they're doing, not letting that energy up. As three is up, and nothing but net.
That will help.
Lavelle Green coming on court and making an instant impact. Forster drives, passes over to Osorobo. Gibbons got space for three, it's up, doesn't drop. Manning grabs the rebound, another 14 for Ipswich. Gibbons inside, it's a tough pass. And out of bounds, so it's going to go with CoLA. Ipswich again picking up full court. Stutz needs to get the ball in into Clark. Over to Green. And oh, lucky, it's a travel call. So turnover, ball's back with Ipswich. But that's the way you want to try and break that press, Adam. Get the ball in around half court, drive it over.
Uh-huh. Foster, oh, that spin move double. From Lee.
Great pass. And Christabel Osorobo going to head to the line. Another player, again, that's playing in Division 1, averaging 10 points per game, 8.3 rebounds as well. Such an impressive showing from players at this age group.
Yeah.
So, awesome Robo for two. First shot drops. Seconds good, 2 of 2 from the line. Ipswich increased the lead to 19. Stutz into Green. Green needs some help, over to Stutz. Gonna have to get it over the halfway line soon. Stutz driving.
She did really well there to get the ball over the court in time.
Really good job. Green round to Stutz. 2 minutes to play in the first half. Duffy. And nearly stolen away by Edwards, but Stutz keeps it alive and gets it over to Green. And that is, oh, shot clock violation. As Ipswich forcing another 24-second shot clock violation. Forster, triple teamed, pass inside, Manning keeps it alive, Green comes up with it for CoLA, and there we go.
Oh, that was tough.
Jump ball number 53.
In the last minute.
I mean, I think this is why Liv Forster wears knee pads as well. So
well, you know what, I'll tell you what, Kaz, I'm probably twice the weight of Liv Forster, and I wouldn't like to go again. And try and wrestle the ball away from her.
Yeah, Liv Forster, a fantastic player, playing for GB Under-18, the England Under-18 squad. I had the pleasure of commentating at the Four Nations tournament last year in Wales, and hit 7 threes in a game. Very exciting player to watch. Really, really bright future. Really exciting to see where her career takes her. As Edwards at the line.
And we know that I'd imagine our old friend and her dad Jim will be here somewhere.
So I used to play basketball with Jim. And Jim used to play on a team up in Oldham.
Yeah, Jim, of course, rugby player as well.
Yeah.
It's probably where Liv gets this ability to hustle on the floor and scrimmage and scrums from.
As Edwards hits a second, it takes us to 16. And great pass inside as Kersite finishes for CoLA.
Well, Glory Cabay did a great job there, keeping hold of the ball to get the ball down the floor.
Duffy hands it off to Kersite, gets it back. Again, Ipswich really backing off around the three-point line. Cavia fires for two, that one's too short. Manning pulls the rebound down. Forster and Edwards on the break. Forster doesn't drop. Edwards can't get the rebound, and Kabir throws it up ahead. Kersite, and oh, it just pops out. And knocked out of bounds. They're going to stay with CoLA, but Eliza Bartholomew doing a great job for Ipswich to knock the ball out of bounds there, and really playing some tough D, as you see her coming up behind Kersite to put the shot off. Duffy into the corner for Kabir. Shot doesn't drop. Green gets the rebound. 33 seconds. Green shot up. No good.
Beautiful
quarterback
pass.
Pass over to Edwards.
Oh, what
blocked.
A great block, though.
Green over to Kabir. It'll be a driving scoop. Just go. And Ipswich. Edwards, great pass over to Forster on the baseline. And just knocked out of bounds. Going to stay with Ipswich. We've got 6 seconds on the shot clock. Edwards, that was such a great bounce pass over to Forster. So, timeout.
Which way was it called from? I'd imagine someone's going to be wanting to try running a play here, maybe.
So, see what Coach Nick Drain is going to draw up for Ipswich. And CoLA need to put the brakes on this defensively. As we go into the half, you want to get a stop as you go into half. Just 6 seconds left.
Yeah.
A lot of time, obviously, for Ipswich to get a shot off. And you look around, Ipswich have got so many shooters. You wonder who's going to get the ball. Is it going to be Edwards inside, along with Gibbons, or Forster outside for the shot?
Well, I mean, you've got to be looking to either those two. Edwards has been superb. It's, well, all over the court today, but maybe they try and tuck it inside to her.
And CoLA just need to take the time off the clock. 6 seconds, get a stop, head into half-time, you know, with that momentum. So, 40-22 here in the first half to Ipswich. Yasmin Edwards leading the way with 16 points, 3 rebounds. Lynn Forster has 9 points, 2 rebounds, 4 assists and 4 steals. So, Forster will inbound. And ref's just saying the defending player just needs to give it a little bit of space to get the ball inbound. So Forster. And it's knocked out by Sega. It's going to stay with Ipswich. So I think they're just resetting the time. I think there was a beat of a second that came off the shot clock.
I'm going to take a guess that Forster's going to put the ball in and then try and cut somewhere to get for the open shot is my prediction.
Yeah, it looks like she can cut underneath or round to the left in the corner. So ball is in. Gibbons, great pass inside to Gibbons.
That's completely wrong. The most simple play you can do, and how good was that?
Really, really great performance from Ipswich here in the first half. 42-22, a 20-point lead over the CoLA Southwark Pride, led by Yasmin Edwards at 16 points, Olivia Forster on 9 points. CoLA, a couple of players on 4 points apiece, Glory Kabir, and Esther Kersite also on, sorry, Kersite is on 6 and has 6 rebounds to go along with that as well. So, Adam, heading into half-time, CoLA obviously struggling a little bit to break this press that we keep talking about, the defensive pressure that Ipswich are putting on. You go into half-time, how do you come out in the third and try and counter that?
You've got to react to it, you've just got to find a way. I mean, the last thing that Ipswich are going to do is ease up on it. They're going to keep on pressing. They're going to keep playing tenacious defence. But CoLA done well in the second quarter to react to it a little bit better, I think. And it's a 20-point game. I was worried for a moment that it might become one of those blowout-type games, but CoLA have managed to stick with it. So, yeah, they've just got to find a way to answer the defensive press. And like you said before, if the straightforward pass from the baseline isn't there, you're going to have to be looking for your taller players down the court and putting some quarterback passes.
Yeah. So we just see on the replay one of Yasmin Edwards' many tough drives to the basket, making a really difficult shot, making it look easy. And CoLA able to answer at the other end. So we are going to take a quick break for half time and we'll be back with you in around 5 minutes time. Make sure to stay tuned to the Basketball England YouTube channel, like and subscribe, and we'll be back with you for the second half very shortly. National Basketball Performance Centre here in Manchester. We're getting ready for the second half. Sorry, Adam's just adjusting my headset. I'm trying to
adjust myself and I turned Kaz down. I'm sorry about that.
We're here for the second half of the Under-18 Women's Sure Shot National Cup Finals between CoLA Southern Pride and Ipswich. Ipswich currently with a 20-point lead in a rematch of last year's competition in which CoLA took home the trophy. Ipswich looking to put things their way this time and take the trophy back to Ipswich with them. They are currently led by Yasmin Edwards, who has 16 points, and Olivia Forster on 9. Louisa Gibbons chipping in 8 points as well to go along with 6 rebounds. For CoLA, we have Esther Kersite on 6 points, 6 rebounds, and Glory Cabia on 4 points and 2 rebounds as well. So teams coming back on court. And as we said before, Adam, this is a rivalry between these two teams. They've matched up together, so many different age groups, so many different competitions. And Ipswich coming out really, really strong here in today's game. So back underway for the third. Sega spins it round to Stutz. Cabir in the corner. Jacob, she's doubled as soon as she touches the ball. Sega gets it out. Kabir for 3. And that's
beautiful shot. Well, we had the perfect view of that. What a great shot that was. Just the kind of shot that they needed at the start of the second half.
Exactly. That's what you want to see them come out. Ah, Liv Forster backs it in with a huge scoop layup. That looked like she had the best hook shot I've seen. Sega just hands it off to Kersite. A little bit too strong underneath the basket, fighting for the rebound with Gibbons, and it's going to be another jump ball. ...44-25 Ipswich lead. Forster, great pass to Osorobo. Gibbons alone on the 3-point line, shot doesn't fall. And saved in, but CoLA pick it up as Stutz comes down the court. Kersite hands it off to Kabir. Stutz in the corner. I'd like to see her shoot that 3. We've seen her take that. She's a really good 3-point shooter.
Once again, the space in between the 3-point line and Ipswich's defense, willing them into taking them threes. That's not the first 24-second shot violation.
For this quarter, yeah, we had a few in the first half early. And again, Ipswich, with each of them, doing a really, really good job on the defensive side. As Forster controls things for Ipswich. And the pass is knocked away. Cabia comes up with it. And Edwards,
unlucky,
just coming up behind, almost pressures the ball, forces the turnover. Edwards gets it back.
That's
stepping through to the basket. Tough shot, doesn't go. Manning with the rebound, Gibbons is there. Pass over to Forster, intercepted. Oyewele behind the arc. Inside to Jacobs, she's coming up against Gibbons. Manages to finish, but you see, Adam, as soon as Felicia Jacobs gets the ball, she's got 3 Ipswich players on her. They're just swarming inside. And Forster with a deep 3. Connects.
She's feeling it.
That's the Forster range. 14 points for Liv Forster. Oyewele for 3. Can't answer. Jacobs gets the rebound. Goes back inside and puts it back in. And some miscommunication on the pass, bit too strong. Out of bounds, so stays with CoLA. As we're going to have a quick timeout. And CoLA wanting to regroup, discuss how this third quarter started. And Ipswich Adam, never having been on the back foot throughout the game, they've been able to come out really, really strong, shooting well, being able to get inside. So 24 points in the paint compared to 10 for CoLA. And we've seen the defense they seem to be playing. They seem to be leaving that open shot around the three-point line and just clogging the paint.
Yeah. Well, they've got a lot of options because they can go inside or they can shoot from the outside. So, you know, they can do either thing. I'm just wondering whether CoLA needs to sort of react a little bit to the outside threat that they've got and try and bury a couple of threes, because when you're sort of being invited to do it, why not go ahead and do it?
Yeah, and they've got shooters that can hit the three.
Yeah, if we just look at the stats for threes, so what we have at the moment is we have CoLA at just 4 from 19, 21%. But even the Ipswich shooting percentage from three-point range isn't great, 3 from 10. And I'm going to guess that probably 8 of those shots are from Lynn Forster. So maybe you've got to look to that and go, right, OK, they're giving us space at the three-point line. Let's let some of our shooters free.
Yeah, and also, if you've got someone inside that's being double, triple teamed, you have someone open, even if it's just a bit further.
Look for the kick out,
So, Duffy. Kabir into the corner, pass inside to Jacobs, is knocked away, and Edwards comes up with it. 1-on-4 and can't finish that one. That's a tough move. Kabir's pass too strong.
Well, what happened there was she was bringing the ball down court and she knew that the option was on. Now, who was receiving the pass was Ayawal, and she kind of looked at her and shook her head going no, but she'd already released the pass.
Gibbons against Jacobs. Osorobo inside, gets her own rebound. Jacobs takes it away. Duffy working against Forster. Kicks it out, it's going to be a foul. I think that will be the first on Liv. Yeah, first foul on Liv Forster. First team foul for Ipswich this quarter as Shea Oyewale heads to the bench and Lavelle Green checks in for CoLA. And Lavelle Green hitting a big three in the first half when she came on. And pass inside to Kersite as Edwards steals it away, gets bumped. So that'll be a foul on Green, stopping the fast break.
Coming in from the Ipswich side there.
Second foul on Green. And I think that was called on the sportsmanlike actually. So Edwards gets the free throw. And hits the second. So it'll be Ipswich possession. So it's 6:13 to go here in the third. 48-29 Ipswich lead. Balls into Forster. Osorobo against Kersite, gets it to Forster. Six on the shot clock. Forster spins out to Manning for three. Off the glass and in. The bank's open for Olivia Manning.
Cash deposit.
And Ipswich not letting up at all. Carrying on where they left off in the first half. 51-29, a huge three-point basket for Ipswich. And it is getting loud in here from the Ipswich fans. It's all blue. As you see there, huge basket for Ipswich. And they are fired up coming into this game. It's the Blue Army that we can see on our screens.
really is a blue army.
Great, great, I mean, traveling support.
Any time that Ipswich are up here, they travel in, en masse.
So after this game, we'll be bringing you the final game of the day, the Under-18 Men's Sure Shots National Cup Final at 5:45. That's the London Legends versus the London Elites. Then we'll be back tomorrow for the senior finals. Make sure to like and subscribe to the Basketball England YouTube channel and follow along with all the games. Thank you to everybody who's tuned in and watched today's games. We've still got another quarter and a half of basketball and then another game to bring you. And a big thank you again to Basketball England for putting on such a fantastic event, along with our sponsors SureShot, Wilson, Dynamic and SportServe. So back underway here, just under 6 minutes to go in the third quarter. Kabir gets it into Duffy and just goes through her fingertips, so ball's back with Ipswich.
Also ran into some BBL royalty as well, just half-time card. Well, say BBL is playing in Bahrain. Kofi Joseph is in the house.
Oh, nice. Nice to see the support.
Yeah, Kofi's down supporting the weekend.
What a great passing side to Osorobo.
And then if I look to the right, I can also see head coach of the Giants, Vince McCauley, and Nigel Lloyd here.
Great spin move as Gibbons blocks Green. Green out to Jacobs. Nails the two. And also to our left, some BBL royalty as well. Big Mike Bernard, Manchester
Mike.
Giants legend.
Now, of course, the coach over at Myersco.
Forster, three's up.
Oof.
Doesn't drop.
Good rebound.
And
good
Edwards
shot.
Answers there. Huge three from Yasmin Edwards. She's on fire today, 20 points. Into Green. Green thought about the three, drives against Edwards, steps to the basket, great pass underneath, manages to get it back. I think she passed it and got it back and finishes. As Manning's fouled.
Once again, body's getting clattered all over the paint.
And Green again doing a good job coming off the bench. Not played a super long amount of time, but
yeah,
she's making an impact when she does. And that's the second foul on Esther Kersite. Olivia Manning. This is the first. And the second one rolls in. Takes the lead up to 24 for Ipswich. Javier into Duffy. Javier gets it back. Working against Edwards. Round to Green, passes inside. Jacobs to Duffy. Three's up and in and out, unlucky. Green pulls the rebound down, can't finish. Again, I love the hustle that we're seeing from Lavelle Green, Adam.
Yeah, it's just I can't believe how many times players end up on the floor. I mean, just goes to show how tough these players are and what a tough game they're playing.
Edwards keeps control and knocked out of bounds by CoLA. So Ipswich sideline. And you forget as well, I forget how much basketball these players play.
They play
at
a lot
this
of basketball.
Well.
I mean,
it's not just one team.
Yeah, it's not just one team that a lot of them play for. And as well as practice every day.
Balls into Gibbons, working against Green. Out to Manning. Keeps control. Forster driving baseline. She's fouled.
The photographer's under the basket, sure getting hit nice and hard.
It's as hazardous as commentating,
yeah,
when you've got a ball coming this,
yeah,
way. As you can see there, Liv driving baseline, she's just knocked out. And another quick foul on CoLA. So Christabel Osorobo shooting two. And that is the fourth foul on Esther Kersite, which could be a problem for CoLA this relatively early on. Sorobo's first shot's good. And second also good. Increases the lead to 26. Ipswich picking up this full court. Duffy to Kabir. Green's able to just can't keep hold of it, and it goes, the ball goes flying into the Basketball England desks.
But what I like is Gloria Cavi, she goes straight over to the player and says, don't worry about it, forget it, it's done.
Yep.
Let's move on to the next play. Real mature attitude there.
Some great leadership. Green. Kersite. That's a Kabir. Thought about the three. She pulls and fires.
It's a big shot.
She's done that a couple of times. Takes her to 10 points, leading CoLA. Forces floater, doesn't fall. Duffy looking inside to Jacobs. Green. And travel call. Ball is back with Ipswich. So we're going to have a substitution Ipswich. Olivia Manning checks out. And Kerris Leach coming back in. Kerris Leach having already played today in the under-16s game this morning against the Manchester Mystics.
Well, there you go. You talk about how much basketball these girls play. Two finals in one day.
In about 6 hours.
Yeah.
Has forced a shot up. No basket. See, they called the foul before the shot. And foul was on Louisa Gibbons. Her third offensive foul. Sorry, her third foul. That was an offensive foul for Ipswich. And we're going to have a timeout. 59-36, Ipswich lead. Now, coming up next month at the National Basketball Performance Centre here in Manchester, we've got two super exciting GB Eurobasket qualifiers. On the 9th of February, GB will be taking on Estonia, and on the 12th, they'll be facing Portugal as they try and qualify for the Eurobasket. Early bird tickets now on sale on the GB Basketball website, Basketball England website, so check that out, come down to the game, and make sure to support the GB women.
Absolutely, come on down and see some, quite frankly, the best players that you're going to see.
Exactly, yeah.
You know, these players are all very experienced. You've got an Olympian in Azania Stewart.
Yeah. Holly Winterburn. Young player coming through. I mean, she's young, but she's not as young as she was.
Well, yeah, but I mean, it feels like she's been around so long. She's a veteran already. But I mean, any young player wanting to see the best of the best, come down to Bellevue and check out the GB women, because you will not be disappointed. Of course, Chantal Handy, a silver medalist at the Commonwealth Games this last year.
Playing with the Caledonia Gladiators in the WBBL.
So, yeah, great having her in the WBBL.
So back on court here in the third quarter, we've got 3 minutes to play. Green over to Duffy. Duffy, nice. Oh, can't finish the layup. And Kersite just puts it back in. Forster brings it down for Ipswich.
Nice,
passes out.
Step.
And three's up, but doesn't fall for Leach. Kabir fires a three, doesn't drop, but rebound Duffy. Fresh 14 for CoLA. Kabir. Keeps it alive, got 5 seconds to shoot. Green, round to Duffy. Duffy pulls the trigger. Doesn't go, and just gonna Ipswich, as he tried to save it in, just step out of bounds, so CoLA will get the ball back. Down 21 with 2:11 to play. Kabir into Jacobs, she's doubled straight away and stolen away by Liv Forster. She's got Edwards up ahead of her. Forster spins, passes off to Manning, and it's knocked out of bounds, so stays with Ipswich. Bound at Ipswich. And saved in by Edwards. Manning thought about the three, kicks it out. Edwards does try the three. In and out, doesn't go. And Duffy comes up with the rebound for CoLA. Kabir against Forster. Tough shot for Flory Kabir. And over Ipswich. So Esther Kerside heading to the bench for CoLA to get a rest at the end of the third quarter. Leah Clark checks back in. Kabir. Pass over to Green. Green for three. That one's a bit too strong. Edwards pulls the rebound down. She's got pace. And blocking foul. That is going to be called on Zara Duffy. As we see the pace of Yasmin Edwards to get to the basket. Doesn't finish the shot, but she's going to head to the line. First one doesn't drop. Second's good. Takes it to 21. Duffy inside to Jacobs, is knocked away. CoLA control it. Kabir with a tough shot. Jacobs with a follow through. Count it. And she's going to head to the line. Felicia Jacobs with a tough, tough basket. And substitution for Ipswich. Katie York checking in, and Christabel Osorobo headed to the bench. Jacobs finishes the three-point play. Leads down to 17, just under a minute to play in the third. Manning passes out. And great pass inside to Yasmin Edwards. She's shooting 50% from the field in this game.
Ipswich obviously dominating, but that person right there, Yasmin Edwards, has been such a huge part of it. She's had an amazing game.
Duffy, 4 seconds to shoot. Green shot's up. Too strong. Leach hands it over to Forster. 10 seconds on the clock. Forster. Shots up, doesn't go. Jacobs pulls the rebound down. CoLA needs to get something off. 1 second to go. And not going to get it up in time. So, end of the third quarter, 62-43. Ipswich lead. A close quarter, though, Adam, 21-20.
Yeah, I mean, CoLA have done a good job in that quarter, for sure. But the Ipswich pressure's just not showing any signs of easing up any. Yasmin Edwards, for me, has been outstanding.
She's been fantastic, and 23 points so far.
And a huge part of why Ipswich are in the position that they're in. But she shot the ball very well. Well, she 9 from 17 field goals. These are good numbers. And of course, if you look on the stat sheets, they have the thing at the end called the index. What the index does is it calculates your productivity based on how long you've been on the floor with all your stats. So you can't really, it's a stat you can't lie with.
Yeah.
Okay. So at the moment, Edwards has an index of 18, which is the highest on the Ipswich team, is it? No.
Osorobo
has an index of 19. So that, it sort of monitors your productivity based on minutes, and it bases it on your points, your rebounds, your steals, and your overall percentages.
And so, yeah, Yasmin, 23 points, 5 rebounds, 3 steals. Olivia Foster has 14 points, 8 assists, and 5 steals. And for CoLA, Rory Kabir, 12 points, 3 rebounds. And Felicia Jacobs added in 9 points, 6 rebounds, and a steal as well for CoLA. Lavelle Green as well, coming off the bench, around 10 minutes of playing time, 5 points, 4 rebounds and an assist. Adam, I feel like she's had quite the impact of which, been a little bit of a spark, knocking a couple of big shots down. And CoLA still in this. It's tough, it's an uphill battle. But we've still got 10 more minutes of basketball to play.
Yeah, they're going to have a real do-or-die mentality about themselves now coming out into this final quarter. If they want to get back in this, they've got to do it straight away.
Sega controlling things for CoLA as we open the fourth quarter. Stutz to Sega. LA shot doesn't drop. Rebound CoLA. Great job on the offensive boards. Stutz inside to Jacobs. She runs into a wall of Ipswich players. As Edwards comes down the court and lays it in.
Again.
She's been doing it all game long.
25 points.
Jacobs pass over to Oyuele. Knops kicks it out. Sega, and you see again Ipswich not really guarding the three-point line still. The game plan's been to stop CoLA getting inside, and it's worked pretty well. That's Osorobo getting a Sega, kicks it out. Gibbons, three. It's good! Louisa Gibbons with the second three of the game. She opened the scoring with one, she's got one now. That takes her to 11. And we're going to have a substitution. So, Lavelle Green, Zara Duffy, and Glory Cabier check back in for CoLA. Green gets it over the halfway line, passes it off, just going to go out of bounds.
Well, it's a clever pass from Lavelle Green, the no-look pass, but unfortunately the recipient of the pass didn't see it coming either.
It's too good a no-look.
Too good a no-look.
And a travel call on that possession for Ipswich, so CoLA get the ball back. It's late in the game, Adam, but Ipswich, again, still putting on this full-court pressure. They're not letting up.
No. No mercy, it seems to be the message coming from the Ipswich bench, and they're Sure living up to it.
So coming up after this game at 5:45, we have the final game of the day, the Under-18 men's final. It will be the London Legends versus London Elite. So stick around on the Basketball England YouTube channel for that one. Again, Ipswich forces turnover, forces gets it into Gibbons. Edwards is up ahead and, ooh, just spins out. And we've seen Gibbons drive that right lane, the right-handed layup to the basket. She's done it so many times today, just pops out on that one. So we'll have a substitution Cola. Esther Kersite coming out and Freya Hawkins checking in. Kersite as well, playing for GB under 16, we've mentioned as well, Adam. Yeah. Talent on court as an offensive foul call on Ipswich. On Christabel Osorobo, that's her fourth. And she will head to the bench while Katie York comes back in. Hawkins out to Green. Ball's kicked. He's going to stay with Cola. So 14 on the clock. Green. Duffy inside to Jacobs. Jacobs working. Great hook shot. And it's really difficult for Jacobs to get a good look at the basket because as soon as she's touching the ball, she's just got Ipswich players coming at her from all sides. As Ipswich three doesn't go, but Forster gets it back and banks it in. 16 in the game for Forster. Pass inside to Jacobs. Again, kicks it out. Duffy, shots up, nails a three-point shot. Forced a long two, and that doesn't fall. Jump ball call. And gonna stay with Ipswich. Into Gibbons, and tough move from Louisa Gibbons, can't get it to drop, and ball's loose. I think we got a foul. We might have had a couple of bumped heads on that possession. Foul's called, just letting see who that's on. As you can see on the replay, there's Gibbons, puts the shot up, bounces out, gets the rebound. Oh, I think Gibbons and Foster might just bumped heads. Look like they're both okay. Good to see. So Karis Leach coming back in. Liv Foster going to take her first break of the game. Duffy blocked. Edwards on the break, and again Yasmin Edwards, she's been doing it all game long. 27 points to go along with 6 rebounds and 3 steals. Green, she's got a lot of space. Kabir shots up, doesn't drop. Jacobs fighting for the rebound with Manning. And ball is out. It's with Ipswich. So Aaliyah Clark checking in for CoLA. And Felicia Jacobs taking a seat. Aaliyah Clark averaging 6 points per game in Division 1 for the CoLA Southwark Pride this season. Also playing in the WEABL. Three is up and banks it in for Katie York. Ipswich putting on a shooting clinic here today. Duffy round to Green. Duffy, shot doesn't drop. York pulls the rebound down. Hands it over to Edwards. Edwards round to Gibbons. Back to Forster. Forster gets it, drives to the basket and lays it in. 18 for Liv Forster in the game today. She's got 8 assists and 5 steals as well.
Big performance from Liv. On 27 points. Edwards, though, you really love to see her hit that 30.
Always fun to see a 30 piece. And Green and York, I think, were just after the rebound. Time out, CoLA. 76-48, so that last possession, that was a foul call on Olivia Manning. That's her second. So Ipswich looking pretty in control of this one, Adam.
I'd say so, with under 5 minutes left, 76-48. It's a tough one to try and drag your way back in from that, but, I mean, what can you say about Ipswich today? They played the tenacious defence from the minute the ball went up. And they've just showed no mercy whatsoever. The full court press has been coming in from the start. They carried on with that. CoLA just haven't had a response to it.
Yeah, Ipswich have done a fantastic job. As we say, a rematch of last year's final where CoLA came out on top. Ipswich obviously have that in their minds as they're coming into this game today. And they've positioned themselves very, very well. And that's kind of what you want to see from a team as well, isn't it? You get into these situations, you face these teams. CoLA have always been a tough team and a tough team to match up against with regardless of who you are. And Ipswich have been able to really counter them really, really well today.
Yeah. Ipswich just huddled up, taking some advice from their captain, Liv Forster, there. And they're going to want to try and see this one out in style.
As Osorobo brings it down the court, over to Gibbons, hands it off to Forster, that's blocked. Gibbons gets it back. Pass inside to Gibbons. And fighting for the ball again, another jump ball. This time it goes with CoLA. Cavia into Green, looking to get it over the halfway line. Green against Forster, and manages to draw the foul. And that's going to be Forster's third foul.
I want to say that most of those fouls have been in this quarter, because she didn't have any fouls on her for a long time in the game. So she's done well there to use a foul sensibly.
Yeah, you sometimes wonder if that, you know, fatigue can play a part into that, can't you? Yeah. As you get further on into the game. And, I mean, yeah. Liv's had, what, 8 seconds rest? Almost. So, 4:17 to go. In the fourth quarter, 76-48, Ipswich with a commanding lead here late in the game. They've been led by Yasmin Edwards, who has 27 points. Forster fires and hits. 21 points for Liv Forster. And steals it away. Puts the shot up, doesn't drop. Gibbons back out. Forster again gets the ball. Swings it round the baseline. It's intercepted. Green into the corner. Super driving and into a wall of Ipswich players. Forster. Great pass round to Edwards again. Fighting for the jump ball.
The hustle don't stop, the grind don't stop.
We've had so many this game. As Glory Kabir is going to take a seat. She's had a good game so far for CoLA. Leading the way, 12 points, 3 rebounds and a block. And Freya Hawkins back in. Edwards round to Gibbons. Forster. Great pass.
Oh, nice little handoff there as well.
Gibbons picks it up and fires for three. Doesn't drop. Saleu round to Green. Three doesn't fall. Forster on the fast break, going one-on-one. Forster lays it in. She's got 23.
Well, I think Liv's having a nibble at this MVP candidate.
23 points, 8 assists and 6 steals. I think we're having, have we got a hockey substitution here for Ipswich?
Yeah, Nick Drain knows that this one's in the bag, so he sent his bench out there to see things out. Good for him. Let these younger players get an experience of playing in a big tournament game like this.
Oh, you well, eh? Through to the basket.
Oh!
In and out, a tough move from Shea Oyuele.
The only disappointing thing for me is that Edwards doesn't get to hit 30 points.
You love a good 30 piece. But what a game from Yasmin Edwards. 27 points.
Yeah, I don't think there can be any doubt for an MVP in this game. She's been absolutely sensational. But so too is Asarobo. She's had herself a great game as well.
8 points, 11 rebounds, 6 assists as well, and 2 steals. And I think that's what's shown on Ipswich as Oyuole doesn't finish the free throw, but CoLA get the rebound. Isabel's shot's no good. And CoLA again. Jump ball. And Adam, yeah, I think that's what stood out for Ipswich as well. They've got lots of players that can score, and they've got, you know, inside and outside.
Yeah, they've got a lot of options for sure.
I mean, you've got a facilitator like Liv Forster passing out assists, and Osorobo with 6 assists as well. The huge block for Ipswich. Hawkins drives inside, kicks it out to Clark. 3's up, and oh, unlucky. Approaching the 2-minute mark, 81-48, Ipswich. Here in the Under-18 Women's Shoshut National Cup Final. Ipswich just 2 minutes away. Celebrating. The crowd love it. We can hear the chants.
You can hear the Ipswich rhythm section in full effect.
Cowbells, drums, sticks.
They got it all over there. They're quite a tight band, actually.
Duffy passes inside. It's the ball. And that's going to be a foul call. And we see...
There he is. The main man. That's Liv Foster's brother there. He's getting pretty good on the cowbell. I'll tell you what, it's difficult though, Kaz. He's trying to commentate with him sat next to you.
I can imagine that's tough. Shots four for CoLA, Ipswich. Ball is back on the sideline. And it will be Holly Hurd with it inbound for Ipswich. Hurd gets it back all the way to the basket. Doesn't drop, and she's going to head to the line. Hurd doing a great job there. And that foul is on. Just checking who that foul is on. That is on Amelie Soleu. And second free throw is good for Hurd. Ipswich up to 83. Duffy inside. Kicks it back out. Oyuwele. Oyuwele for three. Doesn't drop. Clark gets the rebound and kicks it back out to Duffy. And
good
she
shot.
Hits the three.
Great shot from Duffy there.
So just a minute six to play. Ipswich have got this one in the bag. And Lidamore hands it off. Bartholomew to Hurd driving inside and pass out. Pressured on the pass, just goes out of bounds. And Ipswich are getting ready to celebrate in the stands and on the bench. Duffy brings up the ball for CoLA. Round to Oyuwele. Duffy. Floater doesn't fall. And the ball is knocked out. CoLA get a fresh 14. Duffy, pass inside. Clark out to Duffy again. Swings it round to Oyuwele. Lines up the three. Doesn't drop. Another offensive board for CoLA. Duffy, floater. In, out. And finally back in again. Cartwright hands it over to Hawes. Three doesn't fall for Ipswich. Oyuwele comes up with it. 14 seconds. Up ahead of her, she's got Duffy. Tries to hand it off, but it's intercepted. Clark turns, spins, doesn't get it to drop. Oyuwele with the rebound. Can't put it back in. Ipswich come up with it, and that will do it. Congratulations to Ipswich, your under-18 women, Sure Shot National Cup final champions. They take the win, 83-54 over CoLA Southwark Pride. And you can see the team celebrating on court. All five starters running out on court to celebrate and cheering their fans in the crowd. What a performance from them, and what an impressive performance against a really tough CoLA team that we've seen them face so many times and have caused so many problems for so many different teams.
Yeah, you can see how much it means to Ipswich. They really wanted this one. And let's give them all the credit that they due from the very first play of the game. They came out firing, they played great defense, they always looked in control. Thoroughly deserved win there for Ipswich, with some outstanding individual performances as well. Yasmin Edwards, wow, what a great game she had. 27 points. Liv Foster facilitating, chipping in with 23 points. You know, it's just great to see how much it means to these players, and they finally got it, because after last year, players like Liv were so disappointed. So sweet vindication for them. Congratulations to them.
And great play as well from Christabel Osorobo, 8 points, pulling down 11 rebounds and 6 assists as well. Louisa Gibbons, 11 points, 9 rebounds, 3 assists, 3 steals and 2 blocks, or stops, as Darren Paul calls that combination of stuffs.
Okay.
And for CoLA, credit to them, they kept fighting. It was a tough game for them, and they've had some players with some great play today. So Glory Kabir, 12 points, 3 rebounds and a block. Felicia Jacobs inside, 11 points, 6 rebounds and a steal. And Freya Hawkins as well, 11 points, 5 rebounds. And Esther Kerside, 8 points, 9 rebounds and an assist as well. So massive congratulations to Ipswich and a huge credit to CoLA. They fought hard to get here. They had a strong run through the cup. They're having a really strong run in the league, and I'm sure they're a team that we will see back here again in the future.
Oh, I've got no doubt, and there's players out there as well that've got big futures ahead of them as well. They're under-18s at the moment, so this is it for a lot of them. This season is their last dance, you know what
yeah.
I mean? And
yeah.
then it's into senior level or the pro level or college in the States, academies in Europe, and it's always sweet for them in this final year to come away with a trophy, so congratulations to them.
And especially, as you say, after the heartbreak of last year, after being here last year, coming up a little bit short, much like we saw in the earlier game as well, the teams that have been here and had that experience as well have been able to use that, and you can see the Ipswich team and fans celebrating in the crowd. Huge congratulations to them, 83-54 over CoLA. We will be with you for the presentations of the winner's medal, the trophy, along with the MVP, who I think there's very, very strong contention for Yasmin Edwards on the Ipswich squad. We'll try bring you an interview with Coach Nick Drain very shortly. Again, thank you for tuning in on the Basketball England YouTube channel. We have one more game coming up today at 5:45. We will have the London Legends versus the London Elite in the Under-18 Men's Sure Shot National Cup.
So we're nearly ready to bring the presentation. We're going to try and grab an interview with head coach Nick Drain. As soon as Kaz manages to grab him, we'll go courtside with her.
First things first, massive thank you to our table officials, referees and statisticians, if they could please make their way onto the floor. Tackling the clocks, Jordan Radwell, Charlotte Martin, Ian Roberts, Lucas Agnew, Gatavilla, Stephen Lindo, Daniel Brooks, Shannon Tibbs, Martin Profu, George Montiero, and Owen Martin.
And to see the presentations for the statisticians doing a fantastic job. It's a tough job on the stats throughout the game. And great to see them recognised for the hard work that they do. So, CoLA getting ready to collect their runners-up medals.
A great journey here to the finals here today. Please a massive round of applause for the City of London Academy, a great show of support
from CoLA. Great travelling support in the crowd. They're a tough team, sitting at 3-0 in the Southern Premier Division in the league as well. Came up short today, but as I said, I'm sure we'll be seeing a lot of these players and a lot of this team in the future.
Shane. Oh, yeah, Chloe Kavir, Abigail Isabel, Alicia Jacobs, Sarah Duffy, Violet Stutz, Rhea Sagar, Emily Salou, Esther Kersan, Freya Hawkins, and their coaches, Jackson Gibbons, Ryan Drew, and Jay Williams.
Very shortly.
If we could ask the captain Olivia Forster to make her way to the table.
Captain Liv Forster will collect the trophy for the team.
Give it up for your under-18 women's national champions.
I think the top has just flown off the trophy with a very eager Ipswich team wanting to celebrate. And massive congratulations to them. 83-54 win over the CoLA Southwark Pride.
Finishing with 27 points.
And the MVP, it will be Yasmin Edwards. 27 points, 7 rebounds.
3 steals and 2 assists. Number 5, Yasmin.
And 3 steals. And a huge, huge game from Yasmin. Really exciting player to watch on this Ipswich squad. They've played really well in Division 1 as well. What a game from her today. And a well-deserved MVP for her.
Well, I don't think it was going to be, there was a couple of candidates for the MVP, but Yasmin Edwards was spectacular throughout the game. What a performance from her, what a big moment from her. We're going to try to catch that word with Coach Nick Drain. He wanted to enjoy the moment with his players, and rightly so.
Big shout out to all of you guys coming out to support the game.
Coming up in around about 20 minutes, if you stick with us here on the Basketball England YouTube channel, we will be bringing you the Under-18 Boys Cup Final. And we're going to take you courtside, where Kaz is with head coach of Ipswich, Nick Drain. Over to Kaz. Courtside with Kaz Bullock and Nick Drain.
I'm here with Coach Nick Drain of Ipswich. Coach, congratulations. You were here last year and came up a little bit short against CoLA. You've been able to take the win back home to Ipswich today. How are you feeling after that?
Just incredibly proud of this group of girls. And they've been through a huge amount of off-court trauma and turmoil, some of which has been very well publicised. And the character and the determination that they've shown today is one of my proudest moments as a coach to work with such an inspirational group of girls.
Yeah, and you have a great team, a real all-round team effort as well. Everyone able to get involved, obviously Yasmin and Liv leading the scoring, but you have such a team that can shoot from anywhere, get inside as well.
Yeah, I think we're at our best when we share the basketball and the scoring spread. You know, Liv is capable of scoring 30 and 40 points sometimes. And, you know, it's about trying to play to the whole team's strengths, because it's very easy to watch her go and steal the show. And she's you know, deferred today, has been absolutely phenomenal. And as a consequence, Yaz, Christabel, Louisa, Olivia Manning, you know, Katie York have all shone, and it's a real team win.
Yeah, a really strong offensive performance, but what stood out to both of us today was your defence, really, really suffocating and relentless. You were able to really close down CoLA inside. Is that something you've been working on?
Yeah, we basically spent the whole week trying to, you know, game plan for their size and power. You know, they are, nobody needs to say how well-coached CoLA are and what an incredible program that they have there. And the athletes that they have and the girls that they have are superb. So we knew that we had to try and make them play us from the perimeter today.
Yeah.
And I thought our girls executed that game plan very well.
It works really well. Well, congratulations. I'll let you go and celebrate with the team and enjoy the trip back home.
Brilliant.
Thank you.
Thanks,
Kev.
Congratulations. Thanks, Nick Drain, head coach of Ipswich, talking to Caroline Bullock there at courtside, the winning coach. And as quick as that, Kaz joins us three back at the commentary table.
So, third game of the day, Adam. What a performance from Ipswich.
Yeah, incredible. And I'm really glad that Edwards got the MVP. I thought she was absolutely sensational from start to finish, so well done to her, well done to the whole Ipswich family. There's a lot of them here, so I'm pretty sure that the long journey back to Suffolk's going to be well worth it now.
Absolutely. So we have one more game today coming up. We have the London Legends against the London Elite in the Under-18 Men's Sure Shot National Cup Final. That will be in around 15, 20 minutes' time. I think we have a slightly delayed tip from the original 5:45 tip-off. So make sure to stay tuned to the Basketball England YouTube channel, and we will be bringing you that game next. So thank you for everyone that's joined us so far on the YouTube channel. We'll take a quick break and we'll be back with you very shortly.